डिस्कस अबाउट किप्टो सिस्टम्स। ओके, सो व्हाट इज क्रिप्टोग्राफी? यू ऑल नो क्रिप्टोग्राफी इज द साइंस ऑफ यूजिंग मैथमेटिक्स टू एनक्रिप्ट एंड डिक्रिप्ट डेटा। एंड क्रिप्टोग्राफी एनेबल्स यू टू स्टोर और ट्रांसमिट सेंसिटिव इंफॉर्मेशन अक्रॉस इनसिक्योर नेटवर्क लाइक द इंटरनेट, सो दैट इट कैन नॉट बी रीड बाय एनीवन एक्सेप्ट द इंटेंडेड रिसिपिएंट। सो इट इज द आर्ट ऑफ सीक्रेट राइटिंग, द आर्ट ऑफ प्रोटेक्टिंग प्रोटेक्शन यूजिंग इंफॉर्मेशन, एंड द साइंस ऑफ एनक्रिप्टिंग और हाइडिंग सीक्रेट, एंड इट इज नीडेड फॉर कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी। नाउ फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट ऑफ सिक्योरिटी इज नॉट सिक्योरिटी। दैट मीन्स ऑल सिक्योरिटी शुड बी रिसाइड इन द की। That is what we was discussing in last few classes, that algorithm, the encryption algorithm is open to all, the mechanism everybody knows, but only thing is secret is the key. Your cipher you are transmitting over the channel or over the network, so people can capture it, right? But only thing the maintains the security is the key, and that you have to understand. Okay, so people should not be able to predict the key or just calculate the key out of the cipher or anything. Okay, that secret algorithm could hide secret bugs or secret trapdoors. So you can ask me that why that algorithms are not secret, why not we can develop algorithm and keep it secret among us. Question is that who knows that this algorithm what you are secretly developing and thinking is secure, but there is some bugs into it or there is some trapdoor. Okay, so that when you are transmitting your cipher over the internet, anybody can just read it out. Then algorithms does not exist. So many times you will find not many times, sometimes you will find some, we speak about some algorithm which are called as keyless algorithm, but actually there is no algorithm which is keyless. There is something is acting as a key, like algorithm itself is the key, or input data is the key, that is called auto key cipher, or both usually they are very weak. Okay, then claims that something has not been broken or meaningless, but hard to refute or disprove. That means numbers of times we will find that I also say that these are the algorithm are not being broken yet, but it doesn't mean that it is the ultimate security, because today it is nobody have reported that they as it has been broken, but who knows that tomorrow somebody will come and say here is the proof that I have broken this algorithm. Okay. So unless by Samir or Scopper Smith, so these are the two person who are very well known in the domain of cryptography, and they are they are having huge work in. You will find that in most of the part of the cryptography or information security, they have some work and very good work. And we still, before we start developing anything new, first we read their proposed things, what they had developed. Okay, so they are so these two person are, there are many other also who are good enough to develop and give the first algorithm in the domain. Okay, so what happens in the communication? So we have a public channel, say we have Alice and Bob who are communicating over the public channel like we do, right? Like we send messages over internet, different chat facility we use, or we speak over mobile phone, we send SMS, whatever it is. Okay, they are basically public channel, anybody can tap them, what you are transmitting over the network, whatever network it is. Okay, so if there is somebody called Oscar who is just tapping it, okay, or he is capturing the transmitted messages from the public channel, so this is the threat. Oscar is the threat to us, right? are a threat to Alice and Bob. Okay, so what can be the solution? Alice can use encryption technique using some key. Alice encrypt the message and the encrypted text. You can see here, you know, with a lock. This text is transmitted to the Bob, and Bob have the same key, and Bob decrypt the message using this key. So it can be a solution. Now, definitely, you can say that, sir, if they are not in a, you know, same location, because as they are communicating over the network, then definitely they are not in a, on the same location. Then how will they share the key? So again, it comes with another problem, that of key sharing, how the secret key will be shared among Alice and Bob. So that we will see in a different time. But right now you can assume the thing, the story like that, that when Alice and Bob had met last time, they had shared the key. It is like, you know, purchasing a lock with two keys. We all do, whoever live in a hostel. We purchase, if you have a roommate, you purchase a lock with two key. You give one key to your roommate and one key you keep with you. So same thing. Say they had agreed with a key that okay, every time we will you know, communicate over the public channel, we will use this key to encrypt our message, and you use the same key to decrypt our message. Okay, so this can be the thing. Now, come to cryptology. So I think this is also, you are well known about. Cryptology can be divided into two parts, cryptography and cryptanalysis. And cryptanalysis, you know, it is the method of breaking the cipher, okay? And cryptography is the method of encrypting and securing the message in the ciphers, okay? So it have a, cryptography can be divided into two parts, like private key or secret key encryption and public key encryption. And in private key encryption, you will find a block cipher and stream cipher. And in public key, you will find two kind of public key encryption. One is integer factorization based techniques. Another is discrete logarithmic techniques. Like you know, RSA, you will find in integer factorization. In discrete logarithmic, you will find elliptic curve cryptography. Okay. So these things we are going to discuss in our coming sessions. Basic terminology, I think you all know, so I had told you in previous lecture, so I am just jumping to the next slide. So the encryption process can be just defined like this. You have a plain text, you have an encryption algorithm here, which is represented by capital E, and which generates cipher C. So C equal to E of M. M is the plain text, okay? And C is the ciphertext. So we can think it like this. And on the other hand, at the time of decryption, you have the ciphertext C, and you have a decryption algorithm which is represented by D. So the plain text mass is M equal to D of C. So you can think in this way, okay? So extraction process of the plain text from the ciphertext is known as decryption. Cryptanalysis, I had already told you, this is the attempt to break the cipher and decrypt the ciphertext by illegal user. It is not true, actually. I should be change it. It is not only illegal user, it can be anybody whoever is finding bugs or whoever is finding loopholes in a cryptographic technique is a cryptanalysis. Now, when I had told you in this slide, actually I have not spoken about the K key, right? The key K, right? So as we know that key is the the center point or holds the security or secret, right? So actually the encryption algorithm will look like this. The algorithm E needs two things to execute. One is the plain text M, and another is the key K. Okay, So the ciphertext can be generated in this way, E of MK. So then we will have a ciphertext C. Okay, so notation for encryption. First is key generation. The algorithm must be probabilistic and randomized. So the whatever algorithm you are using to generate the key, it should be randomized enough so that people should not able to guess the key. Okay, and it will give you the output K or output key K. Okay. Then encryption algorithm, we another terminology we use all the time, which takes input key and plain text M and gives output as ciphertext C, which is which can be written as like this, ENC suffix K, that's key given M. Okay, and decryption algorithm, which takes input key K and ciphertext C and generate the output, which is a plain text M. Decryption can be written like this, M equal to decryption given key and given C. So formally the whole thing what we have discussed can be represented in a single line like this: for all possible K, for all possible M, there is a decryption algorithm which can with support of K, which can decrypt the output generated by the encryption algorithm with the support of same key K, okay, for given message M, okay, which will give you the plain text M. So if you just look into this expression a little bit minutely, you can understand that this EKM, this part is nothing but C, and DK of C is M, you know. Right, so all the things written together is look like this, okay. So attack on encryption, encrypted messages. So there is different kind of attacks, and here are the basic classification of them. First one is cipher text only mass, only attacks. That means the attacker have collected many cipher texts and trying to figure out what was the key used, or how the keys was generated, and what was the plain text. Okay, so attacker is having the encryption algorithm, because it is, we have already told that we assume that encryption algorithm is not known to all. So attacker is having the encryption algorithm and ciphertext to decode. Okay, next kind of attack is known plain text attack. So what happens in this? Definitely the encryption algorithm is known, ciphertext to be decoded. So the ciphertext, a set of ciphertext is also known to the attacker, and one or more plain text. So that means here the attacker is little bit more front foot, because they are having the pair of plain text and ciphertext. Okay, if I give you plain text and ciphertext, and if I ask you to try to find out what was the key, so it is a bit easier than only giving ciphertext, right? So that is one. Then chosen plain text. Definitely the algorithm is known. Then ciphertext to be decoded, known. And plain text, ciphertext pair with key chosen by the cryptanalyst. Understand? So cryptanalyst